Okay, I think we'll just get started quickly now and let people slide in as they join on. Thank you all who are here for joining in on this webinar. I hope you can all see my slide deck as it should be. First of all, a warm welcome to this webinar. This webinar will be an inspirational webinar about how you can work in WorkPoint from Microsoft Teams. And just starting out with a bit of practicalities, this webinar is being recorded and afterwards it will be publicly available for you to rewatch and also to share with those of your colleagues that might not have been joining in today because they were not available. So that's it. If you have questions throughout, just enter them in the chat area, and we will we have set off some time for catching up on questions, and all questions are welcome. So as mentioned, this is an inspirational webinar about how we here with WorkPoint see our users working with WorkPoint from Teams as an interface over the last plus year, all users have had to adjust to a new normal of working more distributed in different locations, especially during the global pandemic. And while some of us are moving back into the offices, we are bringing these new habits that we have created and ways of working with us into the offices again. In addition, a lot of organizations are starting to work more and more across borders. It can be regional borders, but national borders, but also those time borders that we have working in different geographies. So many organizations are moving towards a more distributed workforce. And today we will try to inspire you how we see you can work with WorkPoint in Teams, because Teams has really become one of the platforms for doing distributed collaboration. We'll show you a mixture of opportunities that we have. Some we have had for quite a period, some are very new, and some are also just almost in production as we speak. So I hope you will enjoy that. My name is Simone Lafontaine. I'm the commercial product manager here with WorkPoint. And I'm joined today by our CTO, Dominick Cosgrove, who will take you through a bit of a demonstrational session later on. Let's start out about some considerations about how you can work in WorkPoint from Teams. Now, first of all, Teams has really made its way into the daily life of many users. A lot of us got to know it as a great communication option that offers some good and natural ways of chatting and calling people. And some may even feel a little bit forced into Teams as Microsoft is sending Skype into the grave slowly and steadily. But Teams is more than instant messaging, more than online meetings, and more than phone calls. Teams is really about collaboration and providing users with a whole platform for their daily work activities. And in order to collaborate on projects or on cases or with your clients, you need to access information. And you want that access to be easy. You want it to be fast and natural. So with WorkPoint, we are all about keeping information available and accessible to the right people, and to ensure that information is well governed and well managed, and that users can get the overview and access to the information that they need, and also where they need it. Because regardless of the interface you're in, you will need access to your documents. You will need to get an overview of the tasks that you have on your cases and projects, or you will need to be able to create new project budgets or contracts or approvals. All of these things sit naturally within the document management system. And the more easy it is to get access to your document management system, the easier it is for the users to adopt it. So previously, Outlook was one, if not the key interface for a lot of us during the workday, especially when it comes to communication and collaboration with clients and customers and colleagues. So that's why we here with WorkPoint provided our WorkPoint Express plugin for Outlook, because all of a sudden users could have their entire WorkPoint document management system right at their fingertips in the interface that they spend most of their workday in. And we also have it available in Word and Excel and in PowerPoint, because those are the places that users work. That's really one of our key philosophies. We want to be where the user is, and we want to provide the user with an easy and natural way of working in that interface. So it seems like almost a natural thing sitting in whatever interface you're in. It shouldn't feel difficult or unnatural to work in WorkPoint, regardless of the interface that you're in. I hope this is a bit of a well-known view for a few of you sitting out there. This is where you see the WorkPoint Express plugin sitting in Outlook, and we really call this experience the Express experience, because it should be an Express feeling or an Express access to your document management system. But as we see customers moving more and more into Teams, we will have tapped into this transition. And the way we have done that is over different steps. And I'll take you through some of these integration options that we have had for some time, and then move a little bit sort of down the road in terms of, okay, as companies and organizations and users, even especially the user, become more mature and enjoy the different ways of working, we will adapt to that. So our first goal was to enable users to have access to their WorkPoint solution from Teams. The next step was to tap into how Teams is evolving and how users work in Teams. Because if we just sat back about 12, 13 months, quite a few people might have landed in Teams and felt a bit of now what feeling. This was a whole new interface, and Teams and Microsoft themselves with that platform have also evolved quite a bit over the last few years. So we here at WorkPoint quickly made it possible to connect your Teams with your entities in WorkPoint. So for example, if you have a site in WorkPoint that corresponds to your HR department or your sales department, you could create a corresponding team in Teams for that department. Or if you have, for example, a large cross-department project, you could have a team set up for all project participants. We'll tap a little bit more into these two different ways of working later on. Next up, we supported executing all your WorkPoint actions and tasks from Teams. So creating new documents from your template library, or finalizing tasks, or changing the project stage of your ongoing projects. And we did this by supporting to have your WorkPoint solution displayed as a tab in Teams. And then, of course, also from the very first part, we brought in the WorkPoint security and access model, and the many options that we provide for setting up a much more detailed and fine-grained security and access model than what you get in Teams just out of the box. And this benefit really comes because what we do is, with our integration, is that we put WorkPoint as the backend for Teams, rather than the standard SharePoint site that you get with Teams just out of the box. So quickly, we provided our customers with a lot of ways for working in WorkPoint from Teams in a way that was perhaps a little bit a first step for us. So as I spoke about, there's different ways that you can set up your integration between Teams and between WorkPoint. So because different organizations, they have different ways of working, they have different needs, but they can all work in WorkPoint. You as customers sitting out there have different business processes in your solutions, and you need your WorkPoint solutions to match that. And you also need your integration between WorkPoint and Teams to reflect upon that. If you have employees, then they want an easy access to their current projects or clients and their cases and the tasks that they're working on now. But if you have a department lead, that lead person needs to have a more cross-project overview to ensure that all projects are moving along as they should be, that if there are any key risks, they are taken care of according to the business processes, and that you have a monitor level that goes across the department. Then you have another layer, and that's perhaps your organizational managers, because they need to look even across departments for the whole organization to ensure that it's moving along as planned. And these three different ways of working corresponds to different people in the same organization. But and with WorkPoint, we have already solved that in WorkPoint 365 by enabling differential ways of accessing your projects or getting those overview. And now we want to bring, and we have brought, that way of working differently into to Teams. So if we take sort of two different approaches, I like to call it contexts, because it is really the context of, for example, the employee versus the manager sometimes. That's a good example to use. So for example, you can have a team set up for your project department, so all the project employees, they can collaborate on the projects, or it could be cases, or it could be clients. Of course, it depends on what's your usage, but I'll use the projects as an example here. Project participants and then people working in the project department, they can get an overview of their project, and thanks to the security model that and options that you have with WorkPoint as a background, you can also ensure that it is only the relevant employees that can see the relevant projects. They can also get a department-wide overview of open tasks if you have want that option to ensure that if someone has completed all their tasks, they can see that, and that person can see, okay, who of my colleagues perhaps needs a little bit of help. And WorkPoint also ensures that the files that you share in chat, they are stored securely and properly, and that they remain accessible. They remain easy to find. And by having a team for your project department, you're also creating a space for this dynamic collaboration and communication, and you keep the dialogue accessible to the right people. So if we switch that from that context of I'm an employee, I need to get an overview of my task, I need to be able to access my cases and projects, and switch over into a more cross-team sort of way of thinking, because I might not just be working on projects in my department, I might actually be working on a large project that we're running across teams. It could be due to the size of it, or it could be because it's an internal project that only selected people should have access to work on across departments or similar setup. So you can set up also a team that corresponds to that project group. So now we are out of the department context and more into the project context. So now this is not an either that you as a customer have to think about how do I work? Because you might work differently. You might both have a need for having a team for your HR department, your project department, your legal department, but you might also need some teams for those large-scale internal projects or cross department setups that you have. But if we take a look at what would be the benefit of having a team set up to match your project group, then it's, of course, it's easy access to the existing project documents. You can co-author thanks to Teams. WorkPoint ensures that your documents are stored safely and that the right access rights set up for it. And you can manage these things to WorkPoint. And then you can also have a good way of managing those external users that you might need to have in, because sometimes those large cross-team projects, they are not just for your internal organization. You might also need to have an external auditor or a lawyer or a customer to join in and provide information. So there's different ways of working in teams, and WorkPoint can reflect that. Now, that's a little bit of a look at how we at WorkPoint here at first saw that we could start to meet the needs of working in teams and working in WorkPoint from teams. And as we mature, we also see our customers do so, and also the Teams platform. So we have taken a look at some of the new ways that we could see making it more easy and natural to access WorkPoint from Teams, rather than as it's not simple, but just our previous standard way of having your whole solution displayed in a tab, for example, and having a team set up to correspond with your project or your department in Teams. And that keyword highlighted right here is apps. Because I would like to introduce some of our partners. I've already had a little bit of a sneak peek on this, but this is a brand new product from WorkPoint that's coming, and it's called the WorkPoint Teams App Studio. And the Teams App Studio is a studio where you can build apps for your WorkPoint solution. And that doesn't mean that you can only build an app that matches your one solution. No, it means that even if you as a customer have an organizational-wide WorkPoint solution, you can build apps for your dedicated departments or for your dedicated projects. So those two contexts that we looked at a little bit earlier on, you can have that reflected in an app. And what we mean by app is that you design sort of a little workspace for your relevant users to work in. We'll demonstrate this a little bit later on, and then I think it will become quite clear what we mean. Our whole vision was to say that we need this to be easy and natural, because it might be your super users as your customers out there who can sit together with your partner and define, okay, my HR department needs to have these things and these sets sections of our WorkPoint solution available in Teams easily and very naturally. And you can design those different apps and roll it out to your organization. And the whole product is completely no code. All it requires is that you have a URL to the solution that you're setting up for. You have the opportunity to put in your of course your own branding. There's naming. We'll see these things in action a little later on. So that is really the next step of saying that, okay, we are moving beyond the first level of integration that we had binding WorkPoint and Teams together by enabling you to have customized apps for your organizations directly available for your end users. But tapping back into that whole Express experience that I talked about a little earlier on, we're continuing down that path. Because what we did with WorkPoint Express in Outlook was really to say that, okay, how are users working in Outlook? What's the natural way of working? What's native WorkPoint? How can we mimic that? And we continue our Express experience when we are talking Teams, because in Teams, users, they are moving away from email-driven dialogue over to chat-driven dialogue. And that trend we really want to tap into. And we want to do that by making it easy and natural for users to search through their WorkPoint solution. It could be to find a client or a case. It could also be a very natural way of approving a new project or sharing a project or changing the stage of it or creating budgets and approvals or whatever you have set up from your document templates. And be mindful, when we say document templates, you also have the opportunities to have that bound up into taking information about the client or the customer that the contract is made for, and putting that directly into the template that you create. And we want to give users the ability to do this directly from the Teams chat. So, because chat is the new email, a little bit, if you could say that, it's a natural way of starting to interact with WorkPoint, but in a bit of a different way. Because you chat with your colleagues, because it's fast, it's easy, you can do it a little bit quicker than, at least it feels quicker than to just send off an email. So we want to tap into that easiness and that accessibility that you need to have. Okay, I need to just write this guy a fast chat about a project so he can move on. We'll tap into that. And because our philosophy is that when something is easy and natural, it becomes sort of second nature to users. And when users find that something is natural and easy to do, they'll be happy to do it. So we have tried to put in WorkPoint in Teams a little bit like we tried to put it in with Outlook. It's there when you need it. It's not something that you go have to navigate out of the interface that you're in to find something. You should just be able to find whatever you're looking for, share it and access it and do whatever you need to do to your client or to your project exactly where you are. And I think now it's time for a little bit of a demonstration about some of the things that I just showed you. And I'll hand the word over to my colleague Dom to take us through this demonstration.
Thank you, Simone. Hopefully you can hear me.
Yes.
Yeah, perfect. Just check my audio is working. So I'll share my screen and hopefully be able to demonstrate what Simone's kindly be introducing from our Teams app studio functionality and our integration into Teams. So just to start with, I'm in the web client, but obviously this will work in the desktop client as well. From an organization, and depending on your organization policy, the WorkPoint Studio app will be distributable. So you can, through policy, hopefully this part goes. Yep, there we go. We have a policy here where we have the WorkPoint Studio and it's been published. And in this case, we're just publishing to everyone in the organization, but obviously you can control that through your policy. So you can control who gets the WorkPoint app through your policies. So this user I'm logged in has the WorkPoint Studio app installed and available to them. So I will launch it here. I've pinned it to the app bar. Ignore the name up here because it's on our test solution, but hopefully it feels like Teams, it looks like Teams, it's kind of native. We purposely kind of made it to feel like it's part of the Teams environment. Under here, I have a list of my apps. In this case, I've only got one called Webinar, but I can easily create a new app. I won't create a full app, but I'll just show you the kind of the core concepts. So as Simone, all you need, Simone mentioned, all you need to create a app is the solution. Obviously you can create apps for different solutions, but we do need to know about the solution. So I can paste in the webinar, validate, and it's just been validated. So now all these other options light up that I can actually go and start configuring. So I can put in things like the app details, the tabs, message extension, and I'll go through all of these in a sample just from a demo gods perspective. I didn't want to create an app live. So I'll just delete that one. And I'll go in and edit this existing app. So under the app details, it's based on the same solution. But under the app details, I've got a short name. I can put in a full name, a description, and a full description. So I've been very creative with my use of wordage here, but hopefully you get the idea. And then you can brand. So we've got the WorkPoint logo here by default, but if you have your own icons for a HR app, as Simone said, or a case management or a team app, you can introduce your own icons for the apps. The next thing is to configure the capabilities. So firstly, we can add tabs, and I'll show you this from the end user experience afterwards. But as a app configurator, I can go in and I can create one or more tabs. So I've set up a few here already, but maybe I want to go and add a new tab. So these are your personal tabs. And you can say, what type of tabs do I want to add? So in this case, I might want to add a wizard. I can give it a name, maybe create case. I don't have cases, so create company, maybe. And I can go and create entity, and I got customers, so maybe it's create customer. And I can save that. So here you'll see I have some tabs already created. I can go in and modify. Maybe I want to go and change the create project. I can come in here and edit it. I can see that it's correct, so that's fine. But I may also want to go and maybe change the order so I can move my search up. And this will order your tabs from the user's perspective. Notice I'm not saving it anytime. It's automatically being saved. And also the capabilities of the app are being lit up here. So if I only have an app with tabs, then I'll only see tabs. And if I have message extensions, likewise. So under the message extensions, so I'll just show a few more different types of, maybe I want to have a module view. So I can tie it to my customers, for instance, and I can go in and say what view, maybe I select projects. I think there's more views there, and I can say my projects. So I can create. There we go. So now I have my projects and I can maybe move that up. So you can quickly see that you can add tabs very easily. There's very intuitive configuration options. Under message extensions, this is where you can start interacting through the likes of chat and the command bar. So I've created a few here based on WorkPoint search and the WorkPoint wizard, but I can go and add an additional one. So we have two options today. In the future, we'll have more, and Simone will touch on that after the demo. But maybe I want to go and create a wizard so people can perform actions from within Teams. And maybe it is, in this case, create document. I can create a document set, and these are based on the wizards that you have configured in WorkPoint. And if you have the WorkPoint wizard management, you'll have more options for more wizards and more steps that you can add. And you notice down here, I can target where I want the command to be available. So is it just in the command box? Is it in the compose box or is it in the message? And I can select all the different options as I want. So extremely configurable. And likewise, I can maybe go and add a WorkPoint search. So again, I can, based on your WorkPoint configuration, you can define what search scopes you want and what results you want to return. So here I have some of my standard WorkPoint search configurations. So I can just do an entity search, and maybe in this case, I want to search cases. So I just type in cases and maybe a description search cases. And again, because of the context, and search doesn't work in all contexts, you only get the options that are available to you. And I won't save that, but I'll go in maybe again. You have the options very similar to the tabs. I can change the order or change the or edit or delete the commands. So once I've done that, if I am in a global organization that requires multilingual, I can go and set up my languages for each of the tabs and message extensions and the app details. And once you're ready and you've configured your app, you can download and distribute that. That creates a zip file that can then be published through Teams administration or even given to individuals to go and publish or upload themselves, depending again on the organization policy. So to distribute or to install, I can come here and I can go upload my customized app. And because I'm logged in as an admin, I can deploy it to my org and I can select. You can see I did a few of these, so I won't deploy it because I've already installed it. So I have the app here available. I can open it. And within the context, and I've got it pinned on the left-hand side, you can just about see that it's pinned. I have my app that's got all my description and everything else. I've got my tabs that I configured, so my list of customers. I've got my wizard, which is create a project. Maybe I want to create a quick project from here. And I can put in a URL, etc. I won't do that now. I can go and see the list of projects as well. So I've got my customers, my projects. I've got search. This is just an example. Obviously, you can tailor it and tailor the lists and the entities and the search configurations to your requirements. So obviously, I can come in here and maybe search for and I can find my WorkPoint customer. And likewise, I can go and look at maybe cases or projects. So that's my app that I've deployed called Webinar from a tabs perspective. But obviously, we've added some extensions. So maybe I'm going in and I'm having a chat with Megan. I've got various options here. I can start in my command bar and I can just do at webinar. So it recognizes the name of your app that you've given it. So at my HR or my cases, I can select webinar, and then it shows me the commands that I configured. So maybe I want to go and create a search for customers. And in this case, I might do LinkedIn. I can type. Yeah, there we go. So it's found LinkedIn, and I can click on LinkedIn. And it provides a default. So by default, we provide a default layout for an adaptive card with some action buttons. So I can maybe, once I've found that, I can maybe copy that information and send it off to Megan. So Megan now has the information about that customer. So you can do it from the command bar, but you can also do it from the chat itself. So I can do at WorkPoint, or sorry, at webinar. What can I do? Well, in this case, I'll search for project, and maybe it's project orange. and I can find my Project Orange. And I can then send that card again. And finally, because I've pinned the app to the toolbar or app bar, I can actually work from here. So I've got my two searches. So I can maybe come here and search for projects and Orange again. And I find my Orange or maybe customers. And in this case, I'll search for Microsoft. And I can send that. So that's great, but I also added a couple of wizard functionalities. So I have this plus button here, and I can go and say, okay, let me go and create a new customer. It will open up our wizard. And I'll give it a title, maybe Google Ireland, give it an account number, an address. And bear with me while I do this, because it just will demonstrate some of the extensibility options that we offer in the solution. So I'll just nearly there. Postcode. Country being Ireland. Let's say Ireland. For the sake of it, I'll put Norway. Doesn't really make sense. And then put in maybe a logo for that company. And I can save that. Obviously, WorkPoint will go and do what it needs. So I can now close that window and let WorkPoint work in the background. So I'm very easily within the chat and within the Teams environment able to interact with the WorkPoint solution. But while these adaptive cards are a great starting point, we do want to be able to give you the option to tailor these, what we call adaptive cards. So under administration, I have my business modules. And if I come to projects, I can now go to entity presentation. An entity presentation is going to become a core theme for WorkPoint. It's already used in many places, but it's going to be used more and more across the solution. But now I have an option to say, use what to use in Teams. So I've got a basic Teams card at the moment, but I've also configured a more advanced card. And to do this, I basically took the payload and the template and use a online developer, or not developer, UI tool called adaptivecards.io. And in the designer, I can go and design my card based on my data. So once I've created my adaptive card, I can go back and I can maybe change it to my alternative presentation for Teams. I'll just save that change. And I'll do the same for customers. So now when I go back in, I can do exactly the same functionality. So maybe I'm searching for a customer first of all, and I'm searching for Microsoft. And now I get a different format of an adaptive card. So, rather than the standard, and I've changed the buttons and the actions that I want to be able to perform. And it's all done through configuration. And finally, just to kind of demonstrate, I'll take the Project Orange. And there's an alternative layout for an adaptive card. So you've got real flexibility to bring in your own branding and your own custom design layouts to your adaptive card. So when people are working with WorkPoint in Teams, it will feel natural to them. So I think that was my demonstration, Simone. I will pass it back to you.
Thank you so much, Dom. That was a great demonstration. And I really hope that it also shows all of you out there the different possibilities that we are now tapping into. So really, what you can do now is to start and have your WorkPoint experience much more natural into Teams. You could see how easy it was for a user to search for a project if you have projects. So you can, as Dom demonstrated, tailor those actions to match your users' needs, and also those little adaptive cards that you showed as well, Dom. They tailor to match what you need. You know if you as an organization need to have call the project manager or create contract or whatever key actions that you want to have easily accessible. You can get that on your adaptive card. It's not something that we force onto you. We provide a default that hopefully makes sense for many, but we also offer plenty of opportunities to tailor this for you. And I also hope that especially those customers who's joining in now on this webinar see that the Teams App Studio is really a place where you are maybe not your a very end user, but your super user can be part of the process for defining, okay, the people in my department, how do they work, what should be available in an app for them to make it interesting and to bring in all of those elements that you have in WorkPoint very natively into Teams. So while some of this functionality with the whole Teams App Studio and the message extensions that you also covered, Dom, they are very new and really news to the market from our side, I also want to share with you what's coming up next, because we are not done at this journey of bringing WorkPoint naturally into Teams and having that whole Express experience available in Teams. So a lot of customers know that journalizing emails is something that we have been doing a lot in WorkPoint, and we have actually two different products for handling journalization of emails. But what about your chat messages? Sometimes you perhaps receive a go from the project owner to move a project along to the next project phase, or you get a go from a customer or a department lead for starting up a project. And it would be really great if you could document that decision, right? Without having to get the person to always sign a whole contract for it. Of course, depending on the setup that you have, small tasks might only require a documented yes, while your larger projects would require a contract to be available. But for those times where you need a decision to be documented, what about if you could do that through the chat? Because that's where you are communicating. If we look ahead. You might also need to be able to save an entire thread of chats or a dialogue between you and an external or an internal contact. It could be if you have a client who provides a lot of different statements to you that you need to be able to refer back to later on or have a documentation requirement for. Then you need to save all that dialogue that you have. And then, of course, we talked about it earlier, you're being sent something quite a lot of different files via chat. And it would be really nice if those were super easy to store directly into WorkPoint correctly. At least we think so. So that's what we're looking at. This is just a bit of a in production a sneak peek that we are showing you here, but we're working on giving you opportunities for saving chat messages and documents directly from the chat interface directly into WorkPoint. So just as you would journalize an email, you can now journalize chat. And there's plenty of opportunities for setting up what should be the access level to those chats, because you might have an obligation to save dialogue with a customer, but perhaps it should only be accessible to a selected staff group. So WorkPoint got you covered on all of those security setups, and you get the benefit of that on chats that are saved as well. So this will come later during the year, but we believe that it will really be a next step for our users. So now we have made a little bit of space for some questions, if there has come any in the last period here. If you are you have questions that you might ponder a little bit about, and you're not sharing them here, you're more than welcome to send them on afterwards. We'd really like to have a dialogue with you. Dom, can you see if there are any questions in the chat right now?
Just checking now. No, I don't think so.
Well, they are welcome if they come, and as I just said, reach out to us or to your WorkPoint partner if you have questions for that. We really want to help you on your journey with WorkPoint, and especially also on your journey into Teams. So I want to say thank you very much to all of the participants joining in on this webinar. I'm out of slides, and I think we're out of time as well. So thank you very much for joining in. Remember, this will be made available to you, both the slides and also the recording afterwards, so you can rewatch it and share it as you want. Thank you for joining, and see you at our next webinar.
Thank you, everyone.